Hi. Many of you had asked me doubt regarding exercise problem 4 and problem 5 from exercise 14b. So now here is the solution. So you can pause the screen at this point and copy the solution. You know, whenever you want, you can copy this solution from what you see on the screen now. But now I'll quickly explain what exactly I'm doing. All the solution you can copy later on. But the explanation part, so please understand that, and later on you can copy this. So first we'll understand the question. This is square A, B, C, D. Okay, I have drawn that square over here, and then the diagonals intersect at O. That you can, I think you are able to see that. Next, you know, he's chosen some random point P on the line BC such that BP is equal to BO. Therefore, that I am highlighting with this double, with this markings. So, which means that BO is equal to BP. So, immediately we understand that BOP is an isosceles triangle. With these details, he's asking you to show that, you know, 45 degree and 45 degree he's not given in the question. I have written it. I'll show you how it is 45 degree. With this diagram, you know, this is not mentioned yet. 45 degree, it's not mentioned. We are supposed to find it out. With angle POC is equal to 22.5. This is the first thing we need to prove. Next, we need to show that BDC is equal to 2 times POC and BOP is equal to 3 times POC. We need to show this first, then this, then this. Okay, so let's concentrate on the first part, which is angle POC. Which is this small angle POC. He's talking about this. Now, to find this angle, what I will do is consider, you know, first of all, this is a square, and in a square we know that, you know, the diagonals bisect each other at 90 degrees. So which means that if you consider this line D, you know, you can consider any line. I'll consider AC. If you consider this line, then BD is cutting AC into two equal parts, and this will be 90 degrees. So this also will be 90, this also will be 90, this also will be 90 degrees. That's what it means. That's the property of squares. Okay, now let's come. Another thing is this diagonal bisects the vertex angles. So if this is 90 degree, I mean this is 90 degree in a square, and this diagonal BD bisects the vertex angle. So therefore, it will be 45 and this will be 45. You should be clear with that. These are the properties of square. So with this much background, what I will do is now, because of that, you know, this will be 45 and this will be 45. So that's what I have written. In a square, the diagonals bisect each other and it bisects the vertex angles. Therefore, angle OBP is equal to 45. I have written this. Next, what I will do is, if you consider this triangle OBP, OB is equal to PB, and we already know that this is 45. So what is the remaining angle? I can find this particular angle and I can find this particular angle. So what do I do to find these two angles? Okay, so we know that consider this triangle OBP, all the angles together will give me 180. 180 minus 45 I should do. That answer divided by 2 gives me this angle and this angle. So that's what I have done here. In triangle OBP, you know, in triangle OBP, OB is equal to BP and angle B is equal to 45. Therefore, angle BOP is equal to 180 minus 45 divided by 2, which is 67.5. So just now what I have found out is this angle, angle BOP. This is what I found out just now. And the value of this is 67.5. I'm calling this as result 1 or equation 1. Now, this entire angle, which is angle BOC, I am talking about this entire angle BOC is 90 degree. So therefore what I will do is COP, if I want this part, you know, COP is equal to this entire angle minus BOP. Okay, this green part will be equal to this entire angle minus this yellow part. So that's what I have written here. Angle COP, angle COP is equal to COB, which is the entire angle, which minus BOP, and COB is 90 degree, and BOP we found out that it is 67.5. 90 minus 67.5 gives me 22.5 degrees. So angle COP is nothing but angle POC, both are same. COP or POC, both are same, and we found that it is 22.5 degree. Next, we go to find angle BDC. Angle BDC, I will mark it in, you know, a different color here. BDC, he is talking about this particular angle, you know, this angle BDC. Okay, angle BDC will be equal to how much? We know that angle BDC is 45 degrees. Okay. So angle BDC is 45 degree. That's what I have written here. And how much is 45? 45 is 2 times 22.5. And I have written that. And 22.5, just now we found that, is equal to angle POC. Therefore, BDC is equal to 2 times angle POC. So we proved the second result. Next, we need to show that angle BOP is equal to POC. This is the last part. We need to show this. Angle BOP is equal to 67.5 from 1, and 67.5 can be written as 3 times 22.5. This can be written as 3 times 22.5, and 22.5 we have shown here, it is equal to angle COP or POC. So therefore, angle BOP is equal to 3 times angle POC. This is the third result, and we proved this also. That's it. That's the solution. Next, we move to problem 5. So yeah, this is problem 5. I have put up a video regarding this, so you can watch that video for, you know, all the steps. But let us quickly try to I'll give a quick explanation here. What are we supposed to find out and how you can find that? So fifth problem is, you need to calculate angle AOB. You need to calculate angle AOB, then angle BPC, and then angle PCD, and then reflex angle APC. Reflex angle APC. Angle AOB, you need to find out this AOB, and then BPC, this one, after that PCD, which is this angle, and then APC, reflex angle APC. Let me choose a different color for that reflex angle. He's talking about this reflex angle APC. Now, how do we find this? You know, for the steps and all, you can refer to that video. You can pause where all the steps are written out. But I'm just giving you an explanation here. So first, see that, you know, in this diagram, read the question and understand this diagram carefully. It's a square, and then, you know, because it's a square, all the sides are of equal length. And put this here. Okay, all the sides are of equal length. After that, next, and this is an equilateral triangle. ABP is an equilateral triangle. Therefore, I have marked them, indicating that they are of equal length. So if you are clear with this, consider this equilateral triangle ABP. Consider this equilateral triangle APB. In this equilateral triangle APB, this must be 60. All the angles will be 60. Okay. Next. Okay. If you see this line BD, BD is the diagonal, and this is a square. Therefore, this will be 45. this will be 45 degree. Once I know how much is this, how much is this, I can find the third angle in this triangle. I can find AOB. AOB is simply equal to 180 minus 60 minus 45. 180 minus 60 minus 45 will give you 75. So first part is done. Next we move to this is done, AOB, this is done. Next we are supposed to find BPC. Okay, BPC, how can we find BPC? Okay, what I'll do here is, now consider this triangle ABP, again the equilateral triangle. This angle must be equal to 60 degree because it's an equilateral triangle. And this entire thing, angle B, okay, this entire thing is 90 degree. So a part of it 60, remaining part must be 30. So this is 30. This must be 30. So out of 90, one part is 60 and this is 30. If this is 30, you see this particular triangle. Let me choose a different color, highlight this with a different color, yellow. I'm talking about this triangle BPC. BPC is an isosceles triangle. BPC is an isosceles triangle. And you can see that BP and BC, BP and BC, they are of equal length. And this is 30, and this angle, the base angles, this and this must be equal. How much is that? All you have to do is 180 minus 30. 180 minus 30 gives you 150. 150 divided by 2 gives you 75. This is 75. This is 75. So done. Second part is done. So next we move to angle PCD. Okay. This entire angle is 90 degree. Now I'll mark it here. This entire thing is 90 degree. This part is 75. So what is the remaining part? Remaining part is 90 minus 75. So which means the remaining part is 15 degree. This is 15 degree. So I found the value of this one. Lastly, I have to find this reflex angle. So for this reflex angle, what I will do, now consider this equilateral triangle APB. In triangle APB, all the angles must be 60, which means this also is 60. Now here, if you consider, I'll draw this separately. Now this is A, and then here you have P, and then here you have C. So this is 75 and this is 60. 75 plus 60 will be equal to 75 plus 60 will be equal to 135. So now this reflex angle, how much will this be? This will be equal to 360 minus 135, or 360 minus 60 minus 75, or 360 minus 135. And that is equal to 360 minus 135 gives me 225 degree. So the reflex angle P is equal to 225. So we are done with this solution also. For the steps, etc., you just watch the YouTube video. Pause wherever all the steps are written and then you can just copy it down. Next, we move to which problem? From the worksheet, you guys had asked me 11th one and 9th one. 11th one, you need to make use of trigonometric ratios, and it's not been taught. So you can ignore 11th problem. If you know trigonometric ratios, it's very, very simple to solve that problem. So time being, you can ignore that. You will be taught that later. 9th problem. Someone had asked me, you know, I found it difficult. So I'm just explaining that. That's also quite easy. So this ABCD is a parallelogram, he says that. So because it's a parallelogram, this and this side should be equal. So which means 3x minus 1 is equal to 2x plus 2. And that is what I have written here. So solve this, you'll get x is equal to 3. After that, what I do over here is, I need the value of z. Okay, this 102 degrees, so angle B and then angle A, if I add them, I need to get 180 degree. Adjacent angles are supplementary. You add adjacent angles, you'll get 180 degree, or you can just call them as conjoint angles. So angle B is 102 plus angle A is 50 plus Z. So that's what I have written here. 102 plus 50 plus Z is equal to 180 degree conjoint angles. So you can calculate the value of Z. Z is equal to 28. So that is done. Then what else? Okay, if this is 28, just now I found that this is 28. This also must be 28. Okay, I'm talking about this angle. This angle. This also must be 28. Reason, alternate angles. You see a Z shape here, I guess. So this angle and this angle will be equal in a parallelogram. So this is 28, this is 28. So now what happens over here? I found that, you know, here if you see, this is 28. So if I extend this further, this entire angle must be 180. This entire angle must be 180. Here to here is 180 degree. So one part is 28. What is the other part? This must be 180. Minus 28. 180 minus 28. Once again. 180 minus 28. So, and you know, that's what is written here. If you see, in, you know, CAB is equal to ACD alternate angles. So this implies ACD is 28. And ACD plus Y is equal to 180 degrees. Supplementary angles or linear pair. And ACD is 28 plus Y is equal to 180. Y is equal to 180 minus 28, which is 152. Done. 180 minus 28 equals how much? 152. This is how I have proved. You can copy this solution part, but I have given the explanation. So that's it, guys.